This lecture is all about common gate amplifier working at high frequency band. I'll explain the performance of common gate amplifier at high frequency band and also explain the derivation of expression for upper 3 dB frequency for common gate amplifier at high frequency band. I refer my earlier lecture number 12 for the derivation of expression for voltage gain of common gate amplifier at mid frequency band and lecture number 13 for the development of high frequency small signal equivalent circuit for MOSFET amplifiers. Let us start discussion about common gate amplifier right from the characteristics of common gate amplifiers. And there is no phase reversal between input and amplified output waveform from common gate amplifier. And it has low input and high output resistances. That is why it has little signal current attenuation at the input. And it has unity current gain. That's why common gate amplifier is better known as current follower. It has found application in cascode system. As far as circuit is concerned, the basic structure has single stage MOS transistors. And signal ground is achieved at the gate terminal. That's why we don't use any resistor connected with the gate terminal. And input signal source and load resistors are connected by using high valued coupling capacitor CC1 and CC2. And we assume there is no body effect. That means body and source terminals are interconnected. And this is the basic circuit diagram for common gate amplifier. The source, drain, gate, and CC1, CC2 are high valued coupling capacitors connecting input voltage source and load resistor to the device. This is the biasing and this is the drain resistor. And at high frequency band, these coupling capacitors, they behave as short circuit. There is no problem. But internal capacitors, CGS and CGD, they don't behave as open circuit. And beyond upper 3 dB frequency, gain starts falling. And the rate of attenuation is minus 20 dB per decade beyond upper 3 dB frequency. At upper 3 dB frequency, the gain falls by 3 dB. At high frequency band, the common gate amplifier behaves as a first order low pass network, which can be represented by a very simple circuit containing R and C. And we can write the expression for upper 3 dB frequency for first order low pass network as FH is 1 by 2 pi RC. Let us have high frequency small signal equivalent circuit for common gate amplifier on the next page. This is all about a small signal equivalent circuit for common gate amplifier working at high frequency band. This is the basic circuit. And this is input voltage source. And this is input resistance to input voltage source. And this is a source, gate, and drain terminals. Gate is common between input and output terminals. And VGS is the potential difference between gate and source. This end is positive, this end is negative. And this is biasing resistor. RD is the resistor connected with drain. RL is the load resistor. And VGS is voltage controlled current source. And R0 is the output resistance of the device. And CGS and CGD are two internal capacitors which don't behave as open circuit at high frequency band. That is why gain starts falling beyond upper 3 dB frequency. And most of the cases, R0 is very high in value. So for simplification purpose, we can neglect this part. And this RL dash is the parallel combination of RD and RL. So this is a simplified small signal equivalent circuit for common gate amplifier working at high frequency band. Now, there are two internal capacitors. And I'll be using open circuit time constant or zero value method for the determination of upper 3 dB frequencies. Because there are two capacitors, so two steps will be involved. In the very first step, I have to select one of these two capacitors. Suppose I am selecting CGS. Then I will consider this capacitor as open circuit or by putting the value of CGD equal to zero so that this will behave as an open circuit. Then I will determine the resistance seen by this capacitor CGS, or technically I will find Thevenin equivalent resistance across the terminals of CGS. Then I will get the time constant for this capacitor. In the second step, I will select this capacitor and consider this capacitor as open circuit or by putting the value of CGS equal to 0 so that this will behave as an open circuit. Then I will find out the resistance seen by this capacitor or Thevenin equal resistance across the terminals of CGD. Then I will get the time constant for this capacitor. On the next page, I'll explain how to derive the expression for upper 3 dB frequency by using time constant for this capacitor and for this capacitor. Now I will explain open circuit time constant or zero value method for the determination of upper 3 dB frequency for common gate amplifier working at high frequency band. Let us start with the transfer function of voltage gain for 2 pole low pass network of second order, because we have two internal capacitors, CGS and CGD. They are corresponding P1 and P2, two poles. And this is the equation of transfer function of voltage gain. And in terms of S domain, in terms of physical frequencies, and just opening the bracket and considering this inequality, we have a very simplified version of the transfer function of voltage gain. And we notice by comparing these two expressions here, there are two terms. This is single power, this is double power, and this is only single power. That means this expression shows low pass network of first order. Now easily we can define only single unified effective upper 3 dB frequency just by comparison. And we can write the expression 1 by omega H is 1 by omega H1 plus 1 by omega H2 is equal to the sum of time constant. This T1 is the time constant corresponding to omega H1 and relating to CGS, and this is equal to RGS CGS. RGS is the resistance seen by CGS, or this is the Thevenin equivalent resistance across the terminals of this capacitor CGS. Similarly, T2 is corresponding to omega H2 and corresponding to CGD and equal to RGD CGD. RGD is the resistance seen by CGD, or this is the Thevenin equivalent resistance across the terminals of this capacitor CGD. Now we can write the expression for upper 3 dB frequency in terms of Hz, that is FH is 1 by 2 pi sum of time constants. I'll be using this expression for the determination of upper 3 dB frequency for common gate amplifier on the next page. As per step 1, I'll select this capacitor CGS and consider this capacitor CGD as open circuit. Now I'll find the resistance seen by this capacitor CGS or Thevenin equivalent resistance across the terminals of this capacitor CGS. For that, following Thevenin theorem, I have to replace this capacitor by a test voltage and simultaneously putting the input voltage source equal to 0 by short circuiting it. Now this is the voltage controlled current source, this is the direction GMVX, and I is the current in this direction. So this IX test current is equal to sum of this plus this current. So this is the test voltage between gate and source or across RS, and this is the voltage control current source, and we are applying now Kirchhoff current law at this node. So IX is equal to I plus GMVX, and this I is the VX divided by the parallel combination of these two resistors. And from this expression we get final expression relating VX and IX. Now we can have Thevenin equivalent resistance across terminals of CGS, which is equal to RGS, is equal to VX divided by IX. That is the parallel combination of these three resistors. Now we can have time constant for CGS, the equivalent resistance, and the value of capacitance of this capacitor, which was here. So this is the time constant for CGS. Now we will calculate time constant for CGD on the next page. As per step number 2, I will select CGD and consider CGS as open circuit. I will determine the resistance seen by this capacitor or Thevenin equivalent resistance across the terminals of this capacitor CGD. For that I have to use Thevenin theorem, and this will be 0 as short circuited, and this voltage controlled current source will be 0. So only effective circuit will be, this is the effective circuit enough for the determination of resistance seen by this capacitor CGD. Now it is very easy. Thevenin equivalent resistance across terminals of CGD is simply RL dash, and this is RL dash is a parallel combination of RD and RL. Now we can have time constant for CGD. It is the equivalent resistance and CGD. Now on the next page, we will determine the expression for upper 3 dB frequency for common gate amplifier using time constant for CGD and CGS. Now we can add time constants for CGS and CGD. So this is the expression for sum of time constant for CGS and CGD. RGS CGS, RGD CGD. Putting the value of RGS and RGD, so this is the complete expression for sum of the time constant. Now for common gate amplifier, we can define and we can write the expression for effective upper 3 dB frequency FH. This is 1 by 2 pi and is the sum of time constants. Now we can have some peculiar points about common gate amplifier, very important one. The very first one is, there is no bridge capacitor between output and input nodes. That is why we don't require Miller's capacitance multiplier. And because of these two reasons, magnitude of denominator is smaller. That is why FH is very high for common gate amplifier. Upper 3 dB frequency for common gate amplifier is a high range. That is why common gate amplifier has found application at high frequency band. So this was all about the performance of common gate amplifier at high frequency band and the derivation of its upper 3 dB frequency.